will be watching this later. Okay, I have got a completely different kind of story to share with you guys today. And I think this is kind of fun. I really enjoy this one. Let me find where to go. There it is. Okay. So this is called By the Waters of Babylon. And this is one of the first dystopian books. It was written way back in 1937. And so this guy was like way ahead of the curve. It's Stephen Vincent Benet. And he's way ahead of the curve of creating these dystopian stories. A lot of them started with him. Okay. So this is kind of fun. It takes place future, very far into the future. And the entire world has collapsed in the meantime. Then you've got these pockets of kind of tribal people who are rising up. Okay. So this story, it's actually 8 pages. I'm not going to have time to read it, the whole thing with you guys in today, okay? But what's going to happen is you've got this kid, well, he's a teenager. I would guess he's probably around your age, okay? And he is trying to become a priest, and so he has to go to the place of the gods where the dead places are. And it's kind of like this trial of bravery that he has to go through there and survive and then come back. Okay. So it says my internet connection is unstable. Can you guys still see and hear me?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Okay. I don't know.
Yes.
I'm not unstable, I promise. Okay. So this story is about him going to these dead places, and he's going to encounter a lot of things that he doesn't have words for. He doesn't know how to explain it. So what's going to happen is after you read through the short story, I've got the list of all of these things that he calls it something, but we would notice something else. And you're going to have to decipher what it is. And I'll do the first few with you, but then you're going to have to figure out the rest on your own. And when we have our class meeting on Thursday, we'll go through that list and see just how well you did. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and read to you like the first page and a half of this, so you can get a feel for the story, and then you're going to finish it on your own, and then I'll show you the page, the handout you're going to do. So, the north and the west and the south are good hunting ground, but it is forbidden to go east. It is forbidden to go to any of the dead places except to search for metal, and then he who touches the metal must be a priest or the son of a priest. Afterwards, both the man and the metal must be purified. These are the rules and the laws, and they are well made. It is forbidden to cross the great river and look upon the place that was the place of the gods. This is most strictly forbidden. We do not even say its name, though we know its name. It is there that spirits live and demons, and it is there that the ashes of the great burning. These things are forbidden and have been forbidden since the beginning of time. Okay, so it's going to be his time that it's been forbidden. My father is a priest. I am the son of a priest. I have been in the dead places near us with my father. At first, I was afraid. When my father went into the house to search for the metal, I stood by the door and my heart felt small and weak. It was a dead man's house, a spirit house. It did not have the smell of man, though there were old bones in the corner. But it is not fitting that a priest's son should show fear. I looked at the bones in the shadow and kept my voice still. Then my father came out with the metal, good strong piece. He looked at me with both eyes, but I had not run away. He gave me the metal to hold. I took it and I did not die. So he knew that I was truly his son and would be a priest in my time. That was when I was very young. Nevertheless, my brothers would not have done it, though they are good hunters. After that, they gave me the good piece of meat in the warm corner of the fire. My father watched over me. He was glad I should be a priest. But when I boasted or wept without reason, he punished me more strictly than my brothers, and that was right. After a time, I myself was allowed to go to the dead houses and search for metal. So I learned the ways of those houses. And if I saw bones, I was no longer afraid. The bones are light and old. Sometimes they will fall into dust if you touch them, but that is a great sin. I was taught the chants and the spells. I was taught how to stop the running of blood from a wound and many secrets. A priest must know many secrets. That's what my father said. If the hunters think that we do all these things by chants and spells, they may believe so. It does not hurt them. I was taught how to read in the old books and how to make the old writings. That was hard and it took a long time. My knowledge made me happy. It was like fire in my heart. Most of all, I liked to hear of the old days and the stories of the gods. I asked myself many questions that I could not answer, but it was good to ask them. At night, I would lie awake and listen to the wind. It seemed to me that it was the voice of the gods as they flew through the air. We're not ignorant like the forest people. Our women spin wool on wheels. Our priests wear white robes. We do not eat grubs from the trees. We have not forgotten the old writings, although they are hard to understand. Nevertheless, my knowledge and my lack of knowledge burned in me. I wished to know more. When I was a man at last, I came to my father and said, "It is time for me to go on my journey. Give me your leave." He looked at me for a long time, stroking his beard, and then he said at last, "Yes, it is time." That night in the house of the priesthood, I asked for and received purification. My body hurt, but my spirit was a cold stone. It was my father himself who questioned me about my dreams. He bade me look into the smoke and the fire and see, and I saw and told what I saw. It was what I have always seen, a river, and beyond it, a great dead place, and in it, the gods walking. I have always thought about that. His eyes were stern when I told him that he was no longer my father, but a priest. He said, "This is a strong dream." "It is mine," I said, while the smoke waved and my head felt light. They were singing the star song in the outer chamber, and it was like the buzzing of bees in my head. He asked me how the gods were dressed, and I told him how they were dressed. We know how they were dressed from the book, but I saw them as if they were before me. When I finished, he threw the stick three times and steadied them as they fell. "This is a very strong dream," he said. "It may eat you up." "I'm not afraid," I said, and I looked at him with both eyes. My voice sounded thin in my ears, but that was because of the smoke. He touched me on the breast and the forehead. He gave me the bow and the three arrows. "Take them," he said. "It is forbidden to travel east. It is forbidden to cross the river. It is forbidden to go to the places of the gods. All these things are forbidden." "All these things are forbidden," I said, but it was my voice that spoke and not my spirit. He looked at me again. "My son," he said, "once I had young dreams. If your dreams do not eat you up, you may be a great priest. If they eat you, you are still my son. Now go on your journey." I was fasting, as is the law. My body hurt, but not my heart. When the dawn came, I was out of sight of the village. I prayed and purified myself, waiting for a sign. The sign was an eagle. It flew east. Sometimes signs are sent by bad spirits. I waited again on the flat rock, fasting, taking no food. I was very still. I could feel the sky above me and the earth beneath. I waited till the sun was beginning to sink. Then three deer passed in the valley, going east. They did not mind me or see me. There was a white fawn with them, a very good sign. I followed them at a distance, waiting for what would happen. My heart was troubled about going east, yet I knew I must go. My head hummed with my fasting. I did not even see the panther spring upon the white fawn. But before I knew it, the bow was in my hand. I shouted, and the panther lifted his head from the fawn. It is not easy to kill a panther with one arrow, but the arrow went through his eye and into his brain. And he died as he tried to spring. He rolled over, tearing at the ground. Then I knew I was meant to go east. I knew that was my journey. When the night came, I made my fire and roasted meat. It is eight suns' journey to the east, and the man passes many dead places. The forest people are afraid of them, but I am not. Once I made my fire on the edge of a dead place at night, and the next morning in a dead house, I found a good night, little rested. That was small to what came afterward, but it made my heart feel big. Always when I looked for game, it was in front of my arrow, and twice I passed hunting parties of the forest people without their knowing. So I knew my magic was strong and my journey clean in spite of the law. Okay, so that's as far as I'm going to go with you on that one. I'm going to let you continue reading this. And you're going to finish reading it. It's about 8 pages. That was almost 2 pages. So, I mean, it's not super long, okay? When you are done reading it, this is the page that you're going to work on. Both of these are on the website, okay? And so what we have here, our narrator is seeing a lot of really unfamiliar objects, and he has to guess what they are. But these are ordinary objects and places for us. So you need to guess what he is seeing. Okay, let me make this a little bit bigger. So in column A, we have the narrator's words. And in column B, we're going to do our words. So I'm going to help you through with these first few. Okay, so he talks about, and it does go in order of the story. Okay, so you should be able to find it in order of the story. So he talks about a great burning. What could be a great burning, a place of great burning? What would that be? Any ideas?
A desert?
Could be a desert, but it's actually something that has happened. A great burning.
A nuclear explosion?
Yeah, yeah. So it could be like a nuclear war. And what's fascinating about this is this man wrote this in 1937. We didn't have the bombs yet. But he knew what they were working on. He knew what it could be. And so he was guessing what would happen. What would the world look like if there was a great war and a nuclear war? So I love it when there's these authors who write these things and like, they were so smart. They could see what was coming. Anyway, great dead places. What could great dead places be?
Cemetery?
Cemeteries, but bigger.
Mass grave.
So what if they didn't have anybody left to bury people?
Is it the houses that were?
It would be like cities and towns. So these are places, yeah. So if we've got a big war that has occurred and everybody's pretty much wiped out, there's nobody left to bury. And so imagine a city or just even a town where everybody in it is dead. It's kind of funny. I'm sure you've seen footage of people doing these flybys with, you know, drones through New York, Chicago, Los Angeles, Paris. And you can see that it's like deserted, you know? That's what I was thinking of this story when I saw some of those images. I'm like, they feel like the dead places in that story. So it'd be dead places, but there's going to be some destruction. I mean, our towns don't have any of that destruction. These ones do. Okay, so when he says 8 sons, what does that mean?
8 days.
8 days, yes. So you've got the sun goes by 8 days. So he's walking for 8 days to get to wherever this great place is, okay? And he is going to run into a great river. He mentions before that they don't cross this great river, but it is called the Udasun. And right here, I've already given you this one. It's the Hudson River. Okay. So do you have an idea of where he is going to?
Oh, he's heading to the ocean.
Yeah, it's going to the ocean. So what do you think could be the big place of the gods if it is near the Hudson
River? New York.
So he's going to be wandering into New York City after it's been deserted for a very long time. Okay. So it's really fun to read his description. So here we got the Great River. What do you think a God road would be? It's going to be traveling.
Definitely a highway.
Yeah. So like a highway, a paved road. Because his civilization, the way they are right now, don't have roads like that. Okay. So you are going to continue this. There's a number of things, and it actually goes to, there's 2 pages worth, okay? And so there's a couple others that are given to you, and they're just kind of help you along. So this is your assignment for Thursday. Finish reading this story, fill out this page, and then when we meet on Thursday, we're going to see how well you did filling out the rest of these hints, okay? So questions? The Great River, it's going to be just a large river, but it is actually going to be like the Hudson River, I believe, or maybe there's another big river. I can't remember. I'll double check. I thought it was referring to the same thing. I didn't make this chart. Somebody else did, and I just stole it. So I'm like, oh, I love this. Okay. We'll figure it out. I will double check on that. Okay. Other questions about the assignment? What I'm making you do? Pretty easy, okay, but I just find this is really interesting. I love seeing regular things described through new eyes, or somebody else's different perspective. You've got something here, we're always coming at it that direction. What if somebody comes at it this direction? They're like, wow, what is that? To me, it's just cool. So that is what your assignment is. Okay.